Hi everyone, this is Austin from Raw Bliss, and today I wanted to talk about, quote, raw foods, quote, which are not actually raw. So, there's a few things that people need to know when they're starting a raw food diet. And, you know, when I started out, I thought a lot of these foods were raw as well. And, you know, that they were not heated above 118 degrees, which is, you know, when you start to lose the nutrient value of your food. So, a few of these items include things that are going to be in the bulk section at your Whole Foods or health food store, and they're going to be labeled raw. Sometimes it'll say that they are steam pasteurized. This includes any nuts. Any nuts that are in the bulk section, or any nuts that you find in the store, period, are not raw. They have to be pasteurized in order to take the moisture out and to put them in the bulk bins. Otherwise, mold would grow. Okay? Because there's moisture in these nuts when they're picked off the tree. So these, a lot of these nuts are steam pasteurized. It's, you know, it's at temperatures like 150 degrees sometimes it's higher, you know, but if it's a lower temperature, it's still going to be above 118 degrees, I guarantee you that. So nuts are not raw unless you know someone that has a nut tree, or you can go to orchard yourself, pick the nut right off a tree, just eat it. That's the most ideal way, of course. And, you know, thinking about people who eat, like, a lot of nuts, it just doesn't make sense ideally in the first place, because if you would go up to a nut tree, you have to, like, pick the fruit and then take the nut out of the fruit and then eat that nut. You're not going to be making, like, nut butters in nature. You're not going to be grinding up, you know, 2 cups of nuts and, like, doing that or something. So, it just doesn't make sense. Another one of those items that is not going to be raw is cacao powder and carob powder. These both have to be steamed in order to remove the beans and crush them into a powder. Yeah, even carob. I know when I was starting out on a raw food diet, I had raw cacao, raw carob powder. Little did I know, you know, before I did some extensive research, that these are pasteurized. They're steam pasteurized just like the nuts are. And so I just want to make sure that people starting out on this diet know the facts. And it's really important. I'm not saying this to be an elitist or something like, oh, I don't eat those raw gourmet foods or whatever, raw. You know, these things like people make raw cakes or raw macaroons, raw stuff like that. And it's just a bit misleading because they're not 100% raw. And so the last thing I'm going to talk about is dried fruits. Now, you can get raw dried fruits. It should state on the packaging if it's raw. And, you know, these are dried at temperatures below 118 degrees. But again, a lot of the stuff in the bulk section, it's gonna be dried above that at 120 degrees, and you can tell kind of because it's if you ever go to a raw food restaurant or if you dehydrate your own fruits, vegetables, you'll notice that, it's still like chewy. It's still, got a little moisture in there. But these things in the bulk aisle, they're like crispy. They're like nothing left in there. And who knows how long they've been sitting there. And obviously, the longer it sits there, the less nutrients it has. So, yeah, that's about it for this video. Just wanted to spread some awareness. I went through this myself when I started a raw food diet. It took me about a month to find out to cut out all cooked foods, including these raw foods. Let me use that one more time. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to give a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more. And eat raw and stay blissful. Peace out, everybody.